गुड मॉर्निंग, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर स्टडीइंग वेल एंड सबमिटिंग द नोट्स एंड ऑल। वेलकम बैक टू आवर वी वर डूइंग द लेसन द लिटिल बॉबी हूएवर हैव नॉट कंप्लीटेड देयर क्लास वर्क्स कंप्लीटेड इन 3 to 4 days एंड सबमिट टू मी इमीडिएटली। ऑल ऑफ यू आर लिसनिंग? आई वेंट ऑन गिविंग मैसेजेस कॉल्स, few of them have given, many of them have not given, I don't know why, but submit it now quickly within 2 weeks. Okay, there was a boy, little boy who was, hope you remember the lesson. He asked his mother bike on his birthday and mother told, how was your year, you remember? Mother still, isn't it, how you behaved, your behavior? She also told the same thing. You ask God whether you deserve bike or no. So this is a talk between the child and the dog. Letter 1. Dear dog, dear God, I have been a very good boy this year. Okay, he is justifying himself. I would like a bike for my birthday. I want a red one. Your friend Bobby. Bobby knew that this wasn't true. He knew it. This letter will not go to God. God is not going to give him anything. But mother is telling to do in this way. He had not been a very good this year. He knows that. So he tore up the letter and started again to write another letter. Next, letter 2. See, letter 1, letter 2, letter 3, letter 4 is also there. This is your friend Bobby. I have been a good boy this year and I would like a red bike for my birthday. Thank you. Your friend Bobby. Now Bobby knew that this wasn't true either. Even this letter, he was going to tear it off. He knew, he knows this, he is not a good boy this year. So, he tore up the letter and started again. Letter 3. I have been an okay boy this year. I still would really like a bike for my birthday. Bobby is telling truly now, little fellow. Bobby knew he could not send this letter to God either. So, Bobby wrote the 4th letter. Okay. Bobby knew he could not send this letter to God either. So, Bobby wrote the 4th letter, letter 4. God, I know I haven't been a good boy this year. I'm very sorry. I will be a good boy if you just send me a bike for my birthday. Please, thank you. Bobby, do you also do like that, all of you? Nobody knew, even if it was true, this letter was not going to get him a bike. Now Bobby was very upset, little fellow was upset. He went downstairs and told his mom that he wanted to go to church. Bobby's mother thought that her plan had worked, as Bobby looked very sad. Mother is happy. Something is at least trying in to know that he was bad. He wanted to improve himself. Just be home in time for dinner, Bobby's mother told him. Bobby walked down the streets. He went to the church on the corner side. Little Bobby went into the church and up to the altar. He looked around to see if anyone was there. If anyone is listening to him, he is going to tell something to God there. Bobby bent down and picked up a small statue of Mary, the mother of God. He slipped the statue under his shirt and ran out of the church, down the street, into the house and up to his room. He shut the door of his room and sat down with a piece of paper and pen. Bobby began to write his letter to God. He's writing 5th letter. God, I have kidnapped your mother, your mom. Silly small boy, isn't it? If you want to see her again, send the bike, Bobby. Understood, this was a lesson. Now we'll start the next unit. A part of it, reading True Height. This story talks about the feeling of an athlete as he pursues his dream. Read about a nerve-wracking down in Michael Stone's life as he prepares to make the ultimate test of his sports career. One of the boy, Michael Stone, is here. He is making his career in sports. Story is about that. It is an awe-inspiring achievement that will leave you breathless. Okay, his palms were sweating. He needed a towel to dry his grip. A glass of ice cold quenched his thirst but hardly cooled his intensity. The astroturf he sat on was as hot as the competition he faced today at National Junior Olympics. He was an Olympic player. The pole was set at 17 feet. There was 3 inches higher than his personal best. Michael Stone confronted that the most challenging day of his pole vaulting career. Understood that the stands were still filled with about 20,000 people, even though the final race had entered an hour earlier. The pole vault is truly gracious, glamorous, even of any track and field competition. The sportsman combined the grace of gymnastic with the strength of bodybuilder. Pole vaulting also has the element of flying. He's a gymnastic, and how what all these trying and feeling it is described over here. And the thought of flying as high as two-storied building is a merry fantasy to anyone watching such an event. Today is not only Michael Stone's reality and dream, it is his quest. As long as Michael could remember, he had always dreamed of flying. Michael's mother read his numerous stories about flying when he was growing up. Her stories were always the ones that described the land from a bird's eye view. Her excitement and passion for details. His mothers, when children are small, mothers used to narrate stories before, isn't it? When they would go to sleep. So Michael's dreams were full of color and beauty. Michael had this one recurring dream. He would be running down a country road. He would feel the rocks and chunks of dirt at his feet. After he raced down the golden line wheat fields, he would always outrun the locomotives passing by. He could begin soaring and like an eagle. Where he flew would always coincide with his mother's stories. Okay, so Michael remembers his mother's stories were full of dreams and beauty. Michael had this one recurring dream. He would be running down a country road. He could feel the rocks and chunks of dirt at his feet. He wanted to become a good athlete. He raced down the golden line wheat fields. He would always outrun the locomotive passing by. He would begin soaring like an eagle. When he flew, would always coincide with his mother's stories. His dad, on the other hand, was not a dreamer, but Stone was a hardcore realist. He believed in hard work. His father was very hardworking, and he believes in it. And sweat, his motto, if you want something, work for it. Real motto, isn't it? Good motto. From the age of 14, Michael did just that. He began a very careful and regimented weightlifting program. He worked out every other day with weights, with some kind of running work on alternate days. The program was carefully monitored by Michael's coach, trainer, and father. Michael's dedication, determination, and discipline was a coach's dream. Stop the lesson here and continue tomorrow. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum. See you in next class.